Right, Byron, how would you describe your style of play?
Oh, okay. Getting straight into it. I don't know, like athletic, kind of laid back kind of style, which some like, some don't, you know. But generally, no, I just try to use my attributes to the best I can, you know. That's okay. About it, try and get as many goals as I can.
Have you got any preferred position or formation? Do you prefer playing up front on your own or with a partner? Or?
That changes from game to game, I think, for me, you know. Sometimes you're really confident and your body's feeling good, you don't mind playing a lone man role. But generally, most strikers would want to play with another striker, you know, especially one whose attributes, you know, work with yours. So I don't really mind when it comes to that.
Have you set yourself a goal target before Christmas and for the end of the season?
Do you know what? This season, I'm just kind of taking it game by game. Obviously, I'd like to get to double figures by Christmas, but the plan for a striker is always 20-plus goals. So I haven't really set that as a target, but that'd be great.
If you could shadow any historical figure, who would it be?
Okay, so this could be... I can pick all the blatant people. Doesn't have to be
anyone. Live. No, anything.
All right, so I watched a documentary on Laurie Cunningham, and his story was very inspirational to me. So I would love to have followed him around, shadowed him, and seen what type of things he went through. You know. So yeah, Laurie Cunningham.
Do you prefer balls through the middle or from wide, in general?
I think both appeal to strengths of mine. You know, I like to attack crosses, but also I prefer to be running onto to balls slip through. So I would say that because that plays to a strength of mine. I like to, some of the defenders we play against are not particularly quick, and if I can get a lot of balls down the sides of them, into channels to face them up and take them on, then I think that. That bodes well for me.
Have you always been a striker?
On the main, I had a little period where, I was playing for my school team and I thought I could do a job as a centre-half. And I did that. I was actually scouted to play for Chelsea, so I was at Chelsea for a little bit. Playing as a centre-half, so I was playing against all these young, good strikers, and all it was is, I wasn't particularly good positionally, just tall and quick, for my age. So it worked out for a little bit, but then in the end, you're a forward playing at the back, so it was never going to be something that was going to be long lasting.
So. How long were you at Chelsea for? Didn't know you were at Chelsea.
It wasn't for long. It was like a trial basis that ended up turning. It was initially like a 2-week thing that turned into like maybe 3 or 4 months. And I really enjoyed that. Just the experience of it, I think any player would tell you they would play professionally in any position just because they want to play, So, well, within reason. I don't really want to play in goal.
Have you learned much from Jamie Cureton, even though he hasn't obviously played much in the friendlies and in training, and obviously a man of his experience?
I've learned that there's life after 37 in football. No, I'm joking. I've learned loads from him. I learned from every striker that I play with. He is a very good one to learn from as well because he has things in his game that I may never have in my game. But that's because we're different builds. Like he's very sharp, and I watch him off the ball, and he always seems to be in space. And his goal record speaks for itself. So he's a man I definitely respect in as a footballer and as a person. We get on well off the pitch, so that's good.
Do you have any match day routines, rituals or superstitions?
Not really. I just try to do the same. I try to do the same things. So, try to get ready at the same time. Come on the pitch. I do a couple of jumps every time I come on the pitch. Just so it's routine, and that's about it. I've got nothing that... I think my new routine would be to try to score every game, so... That's my new routine.
Right, the chairman made some comments in the programme for the Portsmouth game about players not trying maybe as hard as they should. Somebody's asked, have you seen those? And if you did, what do you think of them?
That's the first time I've heard about that. I don't know what to say. That's the chairman's opinion. It's not really my place to comment on his opinion. You know, that's what he's seen, and hopefully I'm not one of the players he's talking about. But if I am one of them players, then that's cool as well. I just get about my job, you know.
What's the biggest argument or disagreement you've had on the pitch with a teammate and from an opposition player?
Like I said, I'm quite laid back, so I don't really get into arguments. I don't really allow myself to get into, you know, little squabbles, especially with my own teammates. That's not something you're generally likely to see. Obviously, everyone says things on the pitch, but that's where it stays, you know, for me and for most players. So, no.
Nothing major?
Nothing major.
Can you switch off on the pitch? If things aren't going well and the fans are maybe having a bit of a go, can you switch that off, or does it affect your confidence and your focus if that's, you know, if the things aren't going well on the pitch and the fans are voicing their discontent?
Yeah, no, I don't think, I think everyone knows that I'm like my own biggest critic, so generally if I'm doing badly on the pitch, I know more than anyone, so I'm kind of like, I'm in the zone, like once I step over sometimes I don't even notice, I don't really notice the fans, only when the game's kind of is still for a second that you actually hear the fans. I'm kind of like in the mode of playing, so I wouldn't say any, I don't really abuse. It is what it is, like some people like it, some people don't. I'm cool with that.
What are your main interests outside of football? Have you got any particular hobbies, even though football's obviously a massive part of it?
Football's a massive part of my life. Football is my life, really. I don't really, everything kind of revolves around this, you know. Obviously I like music and enjoy it. Like I go out with my friends and that, and we have a good time or whatever, but I wouldn't say there's a specific thing that I go out and do, you know. Everything's geared around the season, and then it's holiday time, and then it's season. It kind of goes like that for me, so yeah.
Do you prefer balls, we sort of asked this earlier, but do you prefer balls in the air or on the floor?
Oh, I much prefer the ball to feet, but you know, when you look at how tall I am, I think people just automatically assume that, you know, I should be doing a lot more because of my physicality, but which is fair as well, I have to accept, you know. That comes along with being 6'3", but I much prefer to get the ball down to feet and try and beat a player, or you know, run at somebody.
Do you feel you need to be more consistent?
I've always felt that, but even when I'm having consistent spells, I'm like, you know, I'm like I said, I'm my own worst critic, so I just want to keep playing well. That's it. That's the main thing. That's more than any other goal that I have this season. Even strangely before scoring, it's just to be out there consistently, because if I'm out there consistently, then you know, I can bring consistency to my game and maybe I can score goals consistently. So that's just the aim, is to make sure that, you know, I'm in the starting 11 most weeks.
Someone asked earlier how you describe yourself as a player. Someone else has asked, can you describe yourself in three words in your footballing terms, three words to describe you?
Yeah. Laid back, intelligent, and what else can I put down? I don't know, this is a difficult one.
Athletic is one you used earlier, was that?
Athletic, we'll go with athletic because I'm struggling here, so we'll go for athletic.
Who's the best player you've ever played with?
I think I've answered this question in the other Q&A I did when I first came. It's like I played in a lot of teams where the team's been the focus. There hasn't been like a standout player or a person. Like there's really technically gifted players that I played with, like Robin Shute and Rashid Youssef, you know, players like this, you admire them for those skills, but then they might not have the steel of like some of the players I played with at Stevenage, you know. So everyone brings what they can to the table, and I never look at a person and think, yeah, that they're carrying the team. I always feel like, you know, it's a collective effort, so yeah.
Who's the ugliest player at Cheltenham Town?
The ugliest player? Oh wow. I'm not going to answer that one. I'm gonna pick me, because I don't want to offend anyone, you know.
Too nice to pick somebody. Who do you think is the best goalkeeper in League 2?
Oh, Scott Brown. Everyone knows that one.
How many keepy-uppers do you think you could do if you had to go for a record?
Well, a few would come off the shin, so I'm going to guess. I'm being told 5, but I'm a times that by 10, I'm going to say 50. 50 I'll give you, and then the ball will drop.
Which boots do you wear? All your favourite boots?
Oh, boots. I'm not really a man for the whole boots game, to be honest. I just wear whatever's comfortable. At the moment, I'm wearing Adipures, so those are the boots that I'm for the moment. But they change from season to season, because a lot of people go for like maybe colour, or like they get a little plastic boots. But when you're size 11 feet, it's kind of hard to. You just want comfort.
Are there any particular strikers you've looked up to as you young lad, or idolise, or base your game on?
Yeah, like I said before, I'm an Arsenal fan, so Ian Wright, Thierry Henry, that's these, or even the big Ronaldo. Now, these are the guys you were in the playground as a kid. So it's like those players, they're the ones you call out when you score a goal.
Where do you see yourself in 5 years?
I don't know. I'm very much in the now. So I haven't even thought about that. That's something that maybe I should think about. But I'm trying to live in the moment. You know, trying to enjoy today. You know, sometimes I let myself down. I don't feel like I enjoy the day to day as much as I should. You know, for various reasons, you take it for granted sometimes, but you know, sometimes you sit there and you realise you're doing the job that you've always wanted to do, so, you know, you're thankful again, so.
5 years is a long time. What would you say are the biggest differences between Cheltenham and Wimbledon?
Location? No, what are the biggest differences? I have to say both change rooms were really good, like really nice lads a lot across both change rooms. I'm trying to find big, nothing you're gonna find big differences at this level between clubs. What are you doing? I used to stand there. I don't know what the big differences would be, to be honest. Most clubs at this level, you know, unless they from real money are going to be the same. So
very good answer.
What makes you most happy, apart from David Noble watching your interviews?
Yeah, that's a new one for me. That's makes me happy. I've been told I don't smile enough. I don't know what that's about. I thought I smiled quite a bit. You can show me back the interview. I think I've smiled a couple of times in the interview. So maybe just being around football. You know, a bunch of lads that love football. That's what makes me smile.
Mentioned music earlier. What sort of music are you into at the moment?
I listen to hip hop, R&B, garage, reggae. Yeah, those would be the ones.
Have you ever considered signing up for Twitter?
Never, ever. I've done, but no, it's not for me. None of the social sites are for me, to be fair. I'm way too private, discreet, whatever the word is, you know, that's me.
If you could play up front with anybody, past, present, who would it be?
Oh, me and Thierry would do a job for Cheltenham, definitely. Me and Thierry, yeah, that would be... You can play off me, you know. I want to be the vocal point, so...
What do you hope to achieve at Cheltenham Town?
The same thing I want to achieve in football in general. You know, I want to win stuff. You know, I want to be respected as, you know, as a man and as a player. So those are the things.
And which Cheltenham player makes you laugh the most?
That's said they were nice bunch. I didn't say they was a funny bunch. Don't know. Let's have a look over there. Jermaine McGlashan this season, I don't know what it is. I don't know if he took a crash course in like in Bantner or something. Like it's a little bit better this year, but generally Sammy, because he's just a ball of energy, you know. He's crazy as well, you know. So I've really enjoyed like getting to know him since I've been here. And even Nils can be funny. He tries.
All right, that's brilliant. Cheers, Byron.